Eat this shit up.
This hour, members of the hip-hop community are mourning the shocking death of well-known Port Arthur rapper Pimp C.
A video just released tonight showing the moments before a rapper was shot outside.
Fans and neighbors leaving flowers, candles, notes on rapper Mac Miller's doorstep.
Those two people killed were both up-and-coming Detroit rappers.
They only say the victim, a hip-hop musician named Mo 3, was approached by the killer on I-35.
The LAPD claims 29-year-old Eric Holder walked up to three men outside the rapper's South LA clothing store and fired multiple times, injuring two of the men and killing Hustle. This new
hip-hop and death seem somewhat synonymous. In its brief history, over 80 rappers have been killed. Add that with those that have died from disease, natural causes, or overdose, it's even more than that. In this digital article, we'll list 10 artists that deaths had the most impact on hip-hop. Let's start with Big L. From Harlem, New York, he was killed in 1999. Jay-Z said he had plans of signing Big L, and it was actually a done deal, but he was killed 1 week after beginning the paperwork. His death was impactful to hip-hop for obvious reasons. As lyrically talented as an artist that he was, and being placed under the Rockefeller imprint is reasonable to consider how successful of an artist he would have been, considering the artists that have come out under the Rockefeller imprint, as well as being a big blow to Harlem's rap scene. Nipsey Hussle's death in 2019 sent a shockwave throughout the music industry. He was an artist that was well known and respected throughout the industry, but also did things his way. At the time of his death, he was enjoying the success from his Victory Lap album that was welcoming him to the mainstream. His teachings of entrepreneurship will be applied throughout the urban community as well as hip-hop for times to come. Staying on the West Coast, Eazy-E, who died in 1995, was the founding father of gangsta rap. He died from HIV-induced pneumonia a month after his diagnosis. It's fair to say without Eazy-E, we wouldn't have that strong era of West Coast music, or even have Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, Bone Thugs and Harmony, or N.W.A. meaning we would never have the Friday movie series or anything else that came from that Ruthless Records tree. Obviously, this list isn't complete without Tupac and Biggie, who are the most significant deaths in hip-hop history. Pac was killed in 1996 and Biggie was killed in 1997. Biggie has had over 28 million records sold worldwide, and Pac had 75 million records sold worldwide, with 7 of his 11 platinum albums released posthumously. For obvious reasons, there are two of the most impactful deaths in hip-hop, but caught up as the centerpieces of the East Coast-West Coast feuds occurring in the mid-90s. XXXTentacion. Although some older fans of hip-hop may not understand the significance of his death in 2018, but amongst his era, his death was a very significant loss. He pushed the envelope of music and creativity, and some may not even categorize his music as rap. He was one of the first artists to receive a major cult following through SoundCloud and helped spearhead the SoundCloud rap era. He was a promising musical artist, knowing how to play both the piano and guitar. Their life was cut short at the age of 20. The influence from this DJ slash artist is responsible for an entire sound and era of music. DJ Screw, who died in 2000. Autopsy report said it was an overdose of codeine with other drugs in the system at the time of his death. DJ Screw is the originator and creator of Screwed and Chopped music, what some younger fans call Slowed and Reverb. In the 2000s, the music directly coming out of Houston was a reflection of the sound he created and pushed his way throughout the hip-hop industry during the mid-2000s, with artists from everywhere paying homage to the sound by screwing parts of their verses or their ad-libs, or referencing screwing their music. His collective, The Screwed Up Clique, is responsible for creating careers for several artists, and his influence is still being felt today. Early 2020, Pop Smoke was murdered. To New York, he was a major factor on the rise and possibly stumped the growth and reestablishment of New York in the music scene with his drill music. His debut album was executive produced by 50 Cent, which is a credible and powerful cosign. The power of that cosign is being felt today as his music is being heard widely at chart-topping rates. His extraction from society will be felt in New York for a while, especially in this generation. Dallas rapper Mo 3 died late 2020 from gunshot wounds after being hit up on a highway in Dallas. 3 may not have been as big of an artist as some of the others on his list at the time of his death, but he was definitely a star in the making. Easily one of the most talented rappers inside the borders of Texas at the time of his demise. Dallas' music scene is just beginning to thrive in the mainstream, and Mo 3 was a major piece of that puzzle that's now gone. Last but not least, Pimp C, one of our favorites of all time, a Port Arthur native that relocated to Houston. He was the voice of the South, without a doubt, and his words and presence still being felt around hip-hop to date. At the time of his death, he had only been home from prison about 2 years, so the game hadn't had the chance to fully appreciate Pimp C to the magnitude that it would have liked. He had a long career, but his time in the spotlight was short-lived from the time he was incarcerated waiting for his release, and the Free Pimp C campaign was happening around 2005 until his death in 2007. I hope we didn't miss out any artists that you think death impacted hip-hop more than these, but we tried to be fair for the sake of hip-hop as a whole and recognize each side of the map. This is Hype South with Child Time TV. Until next time, peace.
Eat this up.
Thanks for watching. For more all-exclusive, all-original content all the time, subscribe to Child Time TV.